The other day, Justin7W7 asked me, "Hey Daniel, could you show us how to do that effect where you're speaking and the words start appearing?"
Yep.
Stick around. I'll show you how.
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
The first thing I did was find Justin's comments on my YouTube channel. When I found it, all I did was use my keyboard and hit print screen so that it would save the image that I'm looking at. I then opened up Microsoft Paint and hit paste. That put it into Microsoft Paint for me. I clicked on the select feature in the upper left and chose a blank spot in the screen. I then clicked copy and paste. That replicated the color of the blank portion of the screen. I dragged that down and stretched it out so it covered his actual comment. Sorry, Justin, nothing personal. Then I did the same. I pasted one more time and brought it down over my comment just to block out the words I had typed. Then I used the select feature just to isolate the area where Justin and I were having a conversation. I hit crop and then I saved this to my computer. Then in Filmora, I brought in that image. Bringing it down to my timeline, I stretched it out so I had a lot of area to work with. To add the actual text, you want to click on titles, and in this case, I'll just go with the default title that has no particular assignments to it. I'll stretch that out over my image of the comments section, and then I'll double left click on that. Now I can type in whatever I want. I want to bring the font size down to something similar to the image itself. Let's shoot for around 14. And then I want to scroll down to change the font color. It's not quite black that tends to be used in these YouTube channels. It's sort of a dark gray, so let's go with that darker gray. But you can choose any color that you think makes sense. Let me stretch that out and move it into place. You can do minute adjustments by using the arrow keys on your keyboard. Now, if I hit play at this point, the entire text would just show up when I got to that point. But what I wanted to do is actually feel like it's being typed out. So let's double left click on that text track in the timeline and click on advanced. If you choose the animation feature, you'll see that there is a typewriter animation. Now, to control the speed of that type actually uses two different functions. Right here, you'll see I can slide back and forth. Everything to the left of this bar is actually the motion of the typing. And once it gets to this bar, everything to the right will be completed. Now that's particularly slow for the length I have, so let's pull this way back so it's a faster typing speed. That's much better. And then I can click OK. Now keep in mind, the longer I stretch this in my timeline, the slower the effect will be overall, and vice versa. So if you're using a shorter section of text, when you open up the advanced feature, it will type more quickly. Remember, shortening your timeline means you need to stretch out the effect in the advanced tab. I actually had my audio track pre-recorded, so I brought that into Filmora and dropped that down into the timeline. Listening to my audio, I could time align what was being typed with what was being said.
Yep.
Once you're all done, just export it and you are good to go. Give this a try yourself and let me know how it works out. And don't forget to click on these videos and the ones down in the description below to learn more Filmora tips, tricks, and techniques.
Peace.